This year is real unique because this is the first year we get to pass some serious flows, and today we're passing 14 to 15,000 CFS through the structure right here. The dam was originally built in 1907 and the spillway subsequently after that. And once it reached the end of its functional life in the early 2000s, the decision was made to initiate a project whereby we'd replace the existing structure. And so the structure you see right behind us today was constructed between 2012 and 2015 to achieve that.
Well, the old spillway used to be a manually operated, what they call stop logs, wooden stop logs. They would actually go out and lift those out periodically in different spots in order to control the water flow. I wouldn't want to be the guy that has to go out there and lift that stop log. And believe it or not, they did that all the way until about 3 years ago.
And that capacity was replaced with these radial gates that you see behind me, where the radial gates would now be used to manage the flows by, as opposed to stop logs, which gave us significantly greater operational flexibility.
Now that we can remotely control these gates and monitor them 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, well, just think of the safety benefits of that. I mean, we can control the water at a moment's notice. This year was probably the biggest in probably 22 years of snowfall.
You know, we had a real wet year. For example, in February, the average amount of precipitation we typically get in February, in 2017, in the first 6 days of February, we had already crossed what we typically get in the whole month. Our goal is to fill the system so we have that water for agricultural purposes. But when you have more water than you can hold, you have to convey it downstream. We go into flood operations for the purpose of making space in anticipation of large runoff so as to not increase flood potential downstream from the structures. The neatest thing to me about this structure is just the sheer fact of how much water is capable of moving and still control it remotely. That's pretty unique.
Reclamation is proud. I mean, if you think about it, we've got brand new irrigation canals, BID and MID canals, so the irrigators are happy. We've got an entire new spillway that's controllable remotely. We can control water flows down to a minute amount, up to a great amount, where years past, you couldn't really do that. It was hit or miss. We added all new river gauges downstream so we can really monitor the flow carefully. The wetlands, they're provided water in a certain way where it's that they're all get their fair share. You've got a nice Lake Walcott that is maintained at a constant level now. So I think it's really, really been a feather in everybody's cap, I believe.